then to musical intelligence. Now we're on to the Steinberger guitars, what I call probably the ancestor of the wokeism, meaning that at the time, the 80s, when Steinberger came out, a lot of artists that were showing different aspects that weren't masculine or feminine, but pretty much cross-gender, David Bowie comes to mind, he's not the only one, decided to go with Steinberger guitars and headless guitars because it was a departure from the phallic symbol evocated by Jimi Hendrix, Tiberi Vaughan, and Edward Van Halen with the big headstock and everything else. And as you can see on this baby, no headstock. So at the time, it was a different look, a look not associated with sexism. It was a look purely based on style, fashion. So these guitars were popular throughout the 80s and then fell out of favor in the 90s with the advent of grunge and Appetite for Destruction of Guns N' Roses, where the old styles of the 70s came back enraged. I mean, it was like everything that was 80s when we came, 1990 came around the corner, was trash. Everything from the 80s was trash and everything was trashed, including these guitars. So that's why they fell out of favor. They lost a lot of their value during that time, but now they are back with a lot of offsprings like Strandbergs, Ormsby, Mayonnaise, and so on, and even Ibanez. So we've got, I picked the GP because of all my Steinbergers, it's the only one that's still stock. So it's got the S-trem, the non-transposing on rollers tremolos, leg rest. So I've locked the little lever is engaged, so I've locked it in place. I'm not going to be free floating today, but I could because it's fully functional, it's not broken. So I'll go through the settings on my torpedo remote, Captor X. I'll go through the clean channel on my Peters. I'll do neck through all the settings. Then I'll do bridge through all the settings. And then the second part of this video will be the high gain channel on my Peters. Where I'll do the same thing. I'll do neck through all the settings and bridge through all the settings. To keep things consistent, I'll try to remove as much as I can reverbs and gates and EQs in torpedo, so that we can compare apples to apples and oranges to oranges. So let me do a quick tone test, see if I've got signal. All right, so this works. So I'm onto this, like I said, neck pickup, or bridge. All right, so here we go. Scales. Right, on to the next setting. Gate off, reverb off, here we go. Let me do that again. Check one. Right. Volume's up. Tone is up. All right, let's do that again. Yep. Reverb is off, EQ is off. All right, let's do this again. G chord. Do that again. Seventh. Fifth. Still up, still a neck bridge, a neck pickup. Fret, seventh, fifth. Let's try that again. Let me mute this. I normally would play with a strap. I'm more comfortable with a strap. But it's got shallower pins on it, and I don't have a strap with shallower locks, so I'm playing with the Q cute little leg rest. It's a little low, but I'll make it work. Hopefully you'll be able to tell the difference in tones between the cabs, the settings, and you'll be able to differentiate this guitar from the others I've demonstrated on the videos. Right, EQ off, gate off. Let's go, let's do this again. G. Oh, with volume will be better. This one's a little hotter. Next one, I've got quite a few jingles and bells and whistles on this one. Let me turn them off. Let's go again. G chord. First one, making sure the gate is off, the reverb is off. Bridge, same principle, a few open chords, a few sus2 chords, harmonics, and scale. Fret, 7th, 5th, all right, on the next one, no reverb, no gate, G chord again. G.
it again. 7th. 5th.
A little bit of a scale. To the next one, I'm just going to tune up a little bit. New strings, I'm using 10 to 42. So let me do, that's pretty good. Good that. All right, that's the one. So a little bit of a rotation clockwise. Too much. See, I barely touched it. Do that again. Most. Can you try the others? That's fine. So on the next one, everything's off, volume up, tone up, bridge pickup, G. These are two. Fret, 7th, 5th, a little bit of a scale. Next one, reverb off, get off, G chord. Fret, 7th, 5th, a little bit of a scale. Sounds a little hotter. Let me pull it back at least 1 dB. Yeah, let's do that. 2 dB. G. Thank you.
that again. Seventh. Fifth.
Let me stress that out. The gain on my Peters is barely on. It's at like 2 o'clock. I'm going this way, but it should be here. And last but not least, no reverb, no enhancer, no gate. Let's do that. G. Fret. Do that again. Seventh. Fifth. A little bit of a scale. Settings. Try that again with the neck pickup. Oh, got the gate going. Move that. Let's try this again. Now it's pretty obvious what it is. So what I'm going to do is touch up the amp a little bit. Grab some gain. Grab some boost. Some presence in. Let's try that again. Bottom row, get closer. So the gain's not quite there. I've engaged the boost, crank the high a little bit, raise the presence a little bit, and you can feel the difference. So this guitar responds well. It's fairly quiet considering. If I go two notches on the gain, pickups. So this is the clean section of the tone test. I'll do a separate video that I'll annex to this one. It'll be the same post on YouTube. It's going to be the Dirt Channel and the Peters. And I'll go through neck and pickup configuration on the guitar. So we'll see in about a half second. So let's now do the distortion channel on the Peters. I'll try to move my Peters so you can see it as well as the guitar. It's the top channel on the Peters, so everything's at noon. The boost is not engaged. Eventually I'll do a video about the repeaters itself. So same thing again, I'm gonna go through neck pickup through all my torpedo settings. Whenever I can, I'll try to think of removing the reverb in the gate. Make sure my volume masters are on. I do apologize for looking everywhere around. I'm mixing, producing, recording, animating, hosting, doing everything. All right. So here we go again. G chord. Reverb off, get off, See, the gate's working. I left the gate on this thing. Right, G chord. To mute my reverb, mute my gate. Go back to the original, the top one. Getting any signal, I've muted the speaker in my sound system, that's why I'm using the cans. So everything you hear is through the remote. And might be some bleed from the cans to the lavalier. I'm not sure, but it would be really minimal. All right, next one. G. G chord. The dirt channel. I'm gonna keep this set up. I'm just gonna engage my bells and whistles, my gate, my reverb, my enhancer. So let's get a starting point. Move the camera a little bit. Try to catch more of this. Here we go. So let's do master a little bit more, boost, gain, lower the bass, lower the mid, gain the high, more press, take some depth out. Gain out, get some master in. Me, I gotta turn down the preamp a little bit. Ooh, here we go. California. EQ, reverb, gate. All right, let's try this. switch a little bit. There we go. Let's try this. GP2S with original passive EMG pickups, headless, brand new double ball strings, and it's a mix and match set. I've got about 300 double ball strings here, so I did a 10 to 42 set, mix of GHS strings and the Darios, because I had about two of those 300 strings given to me when I bought a couple of Steinbergers, and I've been stashing them ever since, considering the amazing price they go for nowadays. I keep them really, really preciously. One slight advantage before I leave you to on this is that with double ball strings, you can flip the strings, meaning that when you think they're dead, when they have all these notches caused from the fret eating into the string, you can flip the balls around, and the notches fall into the middle of the fret, and then the fret has some brand new material, brand new metal to gouge, so you get basically the same feeling as a new set of strings, except that they're already stretched. So if you flip the ball ends on a Steinberger, you can pretty much recover the initial amount you've spent on those strings, because they're more expensive than regular strings. And if you buy one of those and you actually have to have your own set of regular strings, there's a few companies that sell an adapter, an aftermarket adapter that goes on top. I have this. Yep, it locates. Let me pull back a little bit. Pins down to these two little holes, and then you can fit regular strings on them. So, from Musical Intelligence, thank you very much. Have a good day.